But this will trigger the Lexus RCF safety car.
Oh, that's big. A big shot. That is a very big crash.
Just getting the right front brakes. So they've got an oil fire down there. Right front brakes were giving them drama. This was second position, this car. And they've got a significant oil fire going. It's brake fluid that's erupted down there. The car put a wheel on. It's got a,
the pads are hanging out.
There was a pad jammed, I thought, that I could see.
You could see the brake pad hanging out the back of it, guys. So
he has flown off the mark with a prop there.
Paul Morris and Mark
Logan. Oh, whoa.
Wow.
I hope he gets out of that in a hurry.
Yes, he's out of it.
Goodness me.
Well, they'll have to stop this.
Did you see the speed of that impact?
No, look, it's going over to Paul
Morris.
Hope
Paul Morris gets out of the car okay here.
Whoa, that's going to go.
Oh, no, there's fuel everywhere. Larkham's out of the car. I hope Paul Morris got out.
Well, I don't think he did yet.
Oh, goodness me. I hope the fire marshals get on the scene there quickly.
I don't. Wright gets a good initial bite. Alex Davison makes a stormer. Slots to the inside. That's massive. Oh, the slot on the grid. He was stalled on the grid. And it's been hit from behind.
That's
and Carl's moving, trying to get out of this car quickly.
So he's gone from the front row. Oh, there's a big fire here.
And Scott Pye. He's had more than enough dramas in 2013 to this stage. And this is really unusual. Look at the back of that car. It's completely burning up.
Is he out?
Yeah, he is.
That's good. Cool.
Whoa.
All right, mate, you're out. You're okay?
Yeah, fine. Yeah.
Thanks, Scott.
Thanks.
He's coming into the pit there.
Is he?
Fuck yeah. Can't start it up. Yes. Drive it down here.
Are we?
After starting this race, the leader.
Greg just trying to get the safety pins away from the bonnet, and the, when you give it a big feed of oxygen, often that encourages the flames, but good news was that the...
Watch this. This is way after the contact, a lap after, and then boom, flash point.
Yeah, so what's happening there is that Mark described before, the oil's getting around whatever's probably...
Boys are diving for the gas at the moment, trying to pump some more air through it so they can actually get those air jacks up and get the car off the ground. They can't do that at the moment, so they haven't completed the tyre stop. Problems for the fuel as well. Oh, there's been a flame. There's a flame here. Goodness me, that happened very suddenly. The boys took the vent bottle out of the back of the car. Officials very smartly are on top of this. And what happened? The guy who was pumping the fuel into the car, goodness me, I was right near that.
Safety car yesterday, safety car today, and here is Jamie Whincup stranded, 888 Ford. Race over for him.
So Daryl was reporting that a piece of the brake rotor is shattered in there. Hard to see from that angle. Certainly a very unusual thing. There's the second fire.
So the WPS Chrysler safety.
Contact with Jamie Whincup. Yeah, I think he's got better speed than Jamie.
Oh.
Trouble, Prema's involved. And we've got a fire here.
David Walls
is one of Bradley's cars, and it's plucked an oil cooler off it.
He's just another innocent victim, really. His car's been turned around, nowhere to go, and it's hit the car pretty hard. The front, I'd say, as you said, it's torn the oil coolers off the car. And that's what the fire's all about.
Clear to go when it drops.
Oh, there's a safety car. We've got a problem with a Volvo here. So this is going to be a game changer. It's Robert Dahlgren that's gone off the road. And typically with the dry grass here in the dry season in winter, it's very easy to ignite. Don't know why Robert's ended up off the road down there, but he's gone off big time. That's triggered a safety car. That throws all the strategy.
Cedo's got plenty of speed down the main straight.
Oh, GJ.
Oh, he's got a fire happening under there too. There's one right under the back of the car. Oh, he's had a big tangle there somewhere, front damage, and he's got a fire underneath. Hope the marshals get onto that before it turns into a major barbecue. Dick getting out, there's the marshals on the scene. I don't know what happened there, but he's really been caught up in a tangle.
Question mark about the slimy track conditions. No, Stephen Johnson, fuel on the road. This is a big, big incident, turn two.
Quite a big accident, turn two.
David Bernard's actually in the car, it's not Stephen Johnson. So safety car will be deployed. We've got 120 litres. They've just gone through the driver change. So it's David Bernard in the car. Out goes the Petters safety car. And this is a very big incident.
Oh, that's Alan Jones.
Alan Jones, the car's on fire, stopped in the middle of the circuit.
Goodness me, Alan Jones. Well, race leader.
That one is going to be in bad shape.
Now, they're
going
to have to get a hell of a lot more extinguishers down there to get that
one
under
control. Fellow isn't going around the other side, and I don't blame him. He doesn't want to get onto the track. Well, looks like they've got it up.
Murph Mark Larkin, this is what was going on. The car just basically exploded as soon as it got into pit lane. They went to business underneath, and meanwhile, Troy was sitting there watching all of this unfold. They unbelievably disappointing. They had done such a good job. Watch this. This thing is an inferno as it comes into pit lane. And by now, he's thinking, I've got to get out of here.
Well, FPR boss Tim Edwards just watching this back now. Tim, any feel for what might have...
Jones was holding down a top 10 position. He'll need to get out of here quickly.
Yeah, he was looking for a Marshall point. He needs to get out of that thing in a hurry. And I don't know where the nearest...
Ooh. Bit of engine smoke. Gone. And it's oil on the rear tyres, that is.
And that'll actually be a problem.
Back there in third. Oh, that's Simon Wills. That's on fire at the start of the pit lane.
And I've been in a car on fire. That'd be very uncomfortable. He wouldn't be able to get out of that thing fast enough. He's hooked up a little bit in the car. We see him probably trying to disconnect his cool suit to get out. But that was a big fire. Fuel fire, it looks like. Very unusual for the back of the car to be burning like that. So there's no doubt that something's going on with the fuel system. Let's have a look and see what happens here.
Well, I don't really know exactly what happened. We went out there. I smelled a bit of fuel on my observation lap, and then... boys had a bit of a quick check over it. They said they couldn't see anything wrong, so then we went out, started the race. Within half a lap, the thing was smoking. Thought, okay, I'll keep pressing on. Hopefully, it'll...
Good at 17. Michael's got the line. Jonathan Webb goes with him and gives Jason Bright a tag. This could be ugly.
Oh, it is ugly. That is a big incident. Ryan Lahard into the back of Jason Bright, and it's on fire.
Yeah, okay.
Needs to get out. This will trigger a safety car. Jonathan Webb started that, he bumped, and he's out. Remember, Carl Reindl was in a very, very big fireball incident on the grid at Barbara.